Very good morning, students. In my previous video, I have explained you about compounds, elements, and mixtures, and why there is a need for separating mixture. So today, in this video, I am going to explain you about methods of separating mixtures. Different components of mixtures have different chemical and physical properties, as we have studied in the previous video that. In mixture, the components or constituents are not combined together chemically, so they possess their own property. Each constituent possesses its own property. Hence, selecting the appropriate method of separation for a mixture depends on the characteristics properties of each component. So now we will look about the properties, about the methods which are used. So as I explained you in the previous video that there are total 6 types of mixture: solid-solid mixture, solid-liquid mixture, then solid and gas mixture, then liquid-liquid mixture, liquid and gas mixture, and then gas-gas mixture, and gas and solid mixture. So these are all were the six types of mixtures. So first we will learn about how to separate solid-solid mixture. So mainly there are 6 methods to separate any mixture in which two solids are mixed together. So that 6 methods are: first, hand picking, threshing, winnowing, sieving, magnetic separation, and sublimation. So we are going to read about these 6 methods of solid-solid separating solid-solid mixture. First one is hand picking. Hand picking is based on difference in size, shape, and color of 2 components, and that has to be separated. So what happened in this method? The component which is lesser in number is picked out using hands. Basically, the components of solid-solid mixture can be separated by hand picking, and this is only useful when particles are large enough to be seen clearly. And this method is the most common method which is used. Like, substances that can be separated by hand picking are types of food grains and pulses having stones, pieces of dirt, husk, etc. For example, separating pebbles from rice or dal. You have noticed that before cooking any rice or any dal, your mom always used to pick the impurities from that rice or dal. So that method of separating the stones and pebbles from any grain or rice is known as hand picking. Separating grass from mint leaves and separating parts of salad. This all are the things in which hand picking method is applied to separate the impurities. Next is threshing and winnowing. So what is threshing? Threshing is the method that generally used by farmers to separate the grains from the stalks after harvesting. The process of separating grains from the stalks of harvested crops, either by beating the salts against a hard surface or by using threshing machine, is called threshing. You can see in the figure, both the things are given. Here the farmer is beating the crop with the hand on the hard surface or stone, or here the threshing machine is used. So this method of separating grains after they harvested, so separating that grain from the crop material, that process is called threshing. The dried stalks are beaten or threshed to separate the grains, or however in large farms, threshing is done by using threshing machines, as I already told you. Next method is winnowing. Winnowing, the process of separating grains, heavy component, from chaff, lighter components, by the action of blowing wind is called winnowing. Now, you have noticed that in grains, some husk-like material is there, which is present, that is called chaff, and that material is very lighter than the heavier grain. So the process in which that light husk are separated from the grain, that process is called winnowing. In the winnowing, the mixture is allowed to fall from a height, and the lighter component gets separated from the heavier ones because of wind or air blow. It is a common method used by farmers. They stand on a raised platform and allow the threshed food grains to fall slowly on ground. here you can see in the diagram, this lady is standing on the higher position, and from there she's dropping the grains, and the chaff which or husk material which is lighter is blowing with the wind and separating at the other side. So this depends on the flow of the wind, like where, in which direction the wind is blowing, we have to set the apparatus like that only. Next, the other two methods are sieving and magnetic separation method. Sieving is used to separate minute particles of different size, passing it through a sieve. Sieve is the all of you know what is sieve. It is used to refine the flour at our home. Different size sieves are used to separate different types of mixture containing minute particles. Sieve is a device containing tiny holes and separate wanted unwanted elements from unwanted material. So here you can see in the diagram, first sieving is shown for refining the flour, and the second one, pebbles and stones are removed from sand by sieving. Most of you have seen these processes in any construction, and simply when your mom would cook in the house. The next is magnetic separation method. Magnetic separation method is the method which is used to separate the magnetic component from the mixture. The method of using a magnet to separate magnetic component from a mixture is called magnetic separation. This method is based on the difference in the magnetic properties of the components to be separated. That is, a magnetic substance get attracted to a magnet. In this method, a magnet is rotated over a mixture so that the magnetic components cling to the magnet while the non-magnetic components are left behind. So take some, for example, take some iron fillings in a china dish, add some sugar to it, take a magnet, hold it with a paper cover over the mixture on iron fillings get attracted to the magnet. Only remains sugar is in the china dish. This method is known as magnetic separation method. As you can see in the diagram, obviously sugar is not a magnetic substance and it will not get attracted towards the magnet. But when there is a mixture of iron filling and sugar, so that iron filling will get attracted towards the magnet when we move that magnet upon the sugar. And that iron fillings get attracted towards the magnet, and in this way the two components can be separated. So this type of magnet in a magnetic separation, in which the magnet is used to separate any kind of mixture in which magnetic substances are there. This is the key point, that the magnetic substance should be there if it has to be separated by using magnet. That method is called magnetic separation method. Now next and the last one is sublimation. You are reading it since class 6. Sublimation is the process where a solid changes from a solid to a vapor without passing through the liquid state. That is, direct change of any solid into its vapor state and then again converting into its solid state without passing through the intermediate state of the liquefaction. This process is called sublimation. So here in the diagram, one method is when apparatus is given in which ammonium chloride salt is there. So when it will get heated, the vapors of ammonium chloride will form on the walls of the funnel which is here. So you can see this one, here it is the apparatus, and here it is burner. This one is china dish in which there is a mixture of ammonium chloride salt. When this ammonium chloride salt will be heated, so ammonium chloride salt has a property to sublimate. It means it on heating, it will directly convert it into fumes or in vapor state without going through the liquid state. So before we follow the process, we have to cover the mouth of the funnel with the cotton plug. Okay, after covering it, once the ammonium chloride salt will be heated, it will get converted into fumes, and that fumes got gathered here, solidified ammonium chloride, and this solidified ammonium chloride on the walls of the funnel is collected, and when that heat, we stopped giving heat or the temperature is stopped increasing, that ammonium chloride is again get converted into the solid form. First it will convert into fumes, and that fumes are collected in the funnel, and after removing the burner, when it comes back to the normal temperature, the ammonium chloride is converted into solid form. So this solid form is called solidified ammonium chloride, and this whole process is called sublimation, in which the ammonium chloride salt is directly getting changed into fume, and after that fume it again getting converted into its solid form. Now next, method of separating solid liquid mixture. Method of separating solid liquid mixture, there are mainly three processes of separating solid liquid mixture: sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Now these three methods are applicable when a solid is insoluble in the water. So first is sedimentation, the process in which the solid insoluble impurities settle at the bottom of the liquid to form sediment is called sedimentation. Example, obtaining clear water from muddy water. So this method is used when a mixture contains component that can be settled down at the bottom of the container. In the process of separating insoluble solid mixed in a liquid by allowing them to settle down is called sedimentation. Now sedimentation takes place due to the difference in the weight of components of solid liquid mixture. So the heaviest solid particle settle down at the bottom of liquid mixture, and the solid particles that settle down during sedimentation are called sediment. And this method is then followed by decantation, in which the heavier insoluble particles that are settled at the bottom are separated by pouring out the top clear liquid into another container without disturbing the sediment. And the process of pouring out the top clear liquid without disturbing the sediment is called decantation. Now sedimentation and decantation processes are used at home while washing pulses with water. The upper layer of water that contains the impurities is decanted, and the sediment pulses are used further. If here you can see that sedimentation and decantation, just suppose there is a mixture of sand and water. So when we allow it to settle down, after some time we will see that in the mixture the sand is heavy, so it will settle down at the bottom. And once it gets settled down at the bottom, we will in this method you can see we will pour out the clear water that is upside into the another container, and the remaining water will remain at the bottom. So this process is called decantation. Now next is filtration. Filtration is the process by which very fine insoluble solid can be separated from a solid liquid mixture by passing it through the suitable pores materials like filter paper. Now in sedimentation and decantation, we have learned that the particles are heavier, so that's why they can settle down at the bottom of the container. But sometimes it happens that the particles are very fine and lighter than the water, and instead of settling down at the bottom, they just float in the water. So for separating such kinds of solid fine particles, the filtration method is used, in which the impurities and insoluble fine particles which are lighter than water are separated by using filter paper and funnel like kind of this apparatus. In this apparatus you can see here it is a funnel which this funnel is the mouth of the funnel is dropped into the beaker, and one filter paper is used here. So this filter paper is used to clear out the impure water in which the finer particles are present. Now one more method is there, that is centrifugation. This one is quite new for you, you will read it first time. The process that involves rotating a mixture rapidly in a closed container to separate a very fine insoluble solid component mixed in a liquid is called centrifugation. And the machine which is used for centrifugation is called centrifuge. So here you can see in the diagram, the picture, this machine is called centrifuge. A centrifuge consists of rotating motor with holes to place centrifuge tubes. You can see here the holes are there, and this is the tube which has to be placed in this hole. This tube contains the mixture to be separated. When the centrifuge is switched on, the motor rotates the mixture at a very high speed, due to which the heavier component settles down at the bottom of the tube, and the sediment in the tube is separated from the liquid by decantation. The lighter components of the mixture remain in the liquid, and this method is used in laboratories to separate cells from the blood, and in dairies to separate cream from milk. So this machine is centrifuge and it contains holes in it. Once the tube will be placed in the holes, that machine will be closed and it will rotate very rapidly. After this rapid rotation, what happens that at a certain stage of time, that finer particles which are in the liquid, they got separated, settled down, and the finer particles will remain. So this process is mainly used in laboratories to separate the cells from the blood, and in dairy to separate the cream from the milk. Now here is one activity which is given. In the previous slides, we have read about the method of separating solid-liquid mixture by three or four kinds of methods are there, and the condition was that the solid particles is insoluble. Now this one is the activity or methods which is used when the solid is soluble in water. So how to separate such kinds of solid-liquid mixture in which solid is soluble? So first, to demonstrate the separation of salt from salt use solution using evaporation method. So here you can see this is the apparatus, and the salt solution is in China dish. We will heat the solution with Bunsen burner and boil the solution until the liquid evaporates completely. Now once the liquid will evaporate completely, the solid white particles of the salts are left behind along the inner side of the china dish after evaporation. Soluble solid present in solid liquid mixture can be separated by the evaporation method in this way. Now next is to demonstrate the separation of solid liquid mixture using the method of distillation. So here is the apparatus for the method of distillation. In this method, the water once first get boiled by the Bunsen burner, and once the water get boiled and it will convert it into vapor state. From here it will that vapor will go to the condenser, and this condenser is covered with cold water. So when the fume will be transferred into this condenser, that will again get back to its liquid form, and that liquid pure water will be collected into this beaker. So this is the process of distillation, this is the process of distillation which is used to obtain pure liquid from solid liquid mixture. The previous slide, there is the method for obtaining solid from any solid liquid mixture, and in this this is the method for obtaining any liquid from a solid liquid mixture. Now next is methods of separating liquid mixture. So mainly there are two kinds of liquid, miscible liquid and immiscible liquid. Miscible liquids are those liquids which can be mixed together completely, or which can mix with each other completely, like alcohol mix with water completely and uniformly. So that alcohol is called miscible liquid. Immiscible liquid that cannot mix together completely, for example water plus oil. Oil cannot mix with water completely, so oil is immiscible liquid. So two different methods of separating liquid mixture. For miscible liquid, there is a method called fractional distillation, and for immiscible liquid, there is a method called separating funnel. So we will discuss about both the methods. So here you can see, this is the setup of fractional distillation. So fractional distillation is a method used to separate a mixture of miscible liquid. This method is based on the difference in the boiling points of the liquid components to be separated. The apparatus used for this method consists of a distillation flask. As you can see here, this is the distillation flask. here it is fractionating column with vapor condenser that convert the vapor into the liquid state again. And what happened in the fractional distillation, when a mixture of two liquids is heated in the distillation flask here, so it boils and vapors rise up to the fractionating column. As the vapors go up in the column, the temperature inside the column begin to decrease. So in the mixture, the liquid with lower boiling point vaporizes first, rises to the top of the column and passes through the condenser. Here the vapors cool down and condenses to form a liquid which collects in a container. The vapors of the liquid with a higher boiling point condense and collect at the bottom of fractionating column itself, as you can see in the diagram. Therefore, both the liquid boil at different temperature and gets collected. And this method is used to get petroleum products from crude oil such as petrol, kerosene, diesel, gasoline, petroleum, gas and tar. So this is all about the fractional distillation. Now next here is separating funnel, separation of the immiscible liquid by using separating funnel. So separating funnel is used to separate a mixture of immiscible liquid. This method is based on the principle that immiscible liquids, that is the lighter liquids, floats above the layer of the heavier liquid. A separating funnel is a glass apparatus that is narrow at the bottom with a stopcock like a tap, as you can see in the diagram. The funnel has an opening at the top of the pour, top of the container to pour the liquid. Here is this opening. After the liquid mixture is poured, it is left undisturbed for some time. Immiscible liquid from separate layers with the heavier liquid at the bottom and the lighter liquid at the top. You can see in the diagram two different colors there are there, one pink and one blue. So pink one is the lighter liquid and blue one is the heavier liquid. When the stopcock is opened, the heavier liquid at the bottom moves out first and is collected in a separate container. This is the stopcock, and when we open it slowly, that liquid will go first in the beaker. When the bottom layer flows out completely, the stopcock is closed. Only the liquid, lighter liquid, remains in the separating funnel, and thus the two liquids are separated. A mixture of oil and water can be separated by this separating funnel method. So this is all about today's video. I'll attach the notes with of this chapter with the link in the description box. So make notes for this chapter, and in next class we will start our next chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.